Hello, this is Rick Haverkate. I'm the National HIV and Hepatitis C Program Coordinator for the Indian Health Service. This short presentation will provide you an update on HIV for American Indians and Alaska Natives in the U.S. I base this brief update on the latest available HIV statistics for American Indians and Alaska Natives. I'm using data from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, reported through December 2019, which includes but is not limited to data from the Indian Health Service. A word of caution as I begin. As shown in multiple studies, and due to missing or misclassified racial data on various health conditions, national disease surveillance data may undercount American Indian and Alaska Native people. The IHS Division of Epidemiology and the CDC are updating HIV data using more recent internal IHS data. HIV is a reportable disease as part of the CDC's National Notifiable Disease Surveillance System. Like all health system providers, the IHS facilities report notifiable diseases to the respective state health authorities, which transmit the data to CDC. The CDC publishes their HIV surveillance report annually. So, let's look at the most recently available American Indian and Alaska Native HIV data. The data comes from the individual states, which report their diagnoses of HIV to the CDC through December 2019. Once the states transmit their HIV data, the CDC's National Center for HIV/AIDS, Viral Hepatitis, STD, and TB Prevention collects and analyzes the data and makes it available to the general public. The figure on the screen is taken directly from the national CDC report, and it shows trends of new HIV diagnoses by race and ethnicity. This graph you see is not fully inclusive of all races in the U.S. For this slide, I've zoomed into a smaller chart of racial groups with lower rates of new diagnoses, and that explains why it does not include all racial and ethnic groups in the U.S. To access the full report, you can scan the QR code on the screen using your smartphone. Although we see some slight variations from year to year, we consider the new HIV diagnoses trend from 2014 to 2018 as stable. The HIV diagnoses rate is approximately 8 per 100,000 for American Indians and Alaska Natives, compared to 5 per 100,000 for whites. Remarkably, in this report, we see that the death rate among American Indian and Alaska Native people living with HIV in 2018 is 30% lower than it was in 2014. The American Indian and Alaska Native death rate has been lower than the white rate for the past two reporting years. We cannot infer any causation on a national scale. Still, we do know that our larger IHS-operated HIV treatment programs, like the Phoenix and Gallup Indian Medical Centers, show outstanding HIV testing, linkage to care, and viral suppression outcomes among their HIV patients. Because our smaller IHS, tribal, and urban Indian health clinics often referred their HIV patients to specialty clinics outside the Indian health system for treatment, it's challenging for our systems to keep track of their individual cascade of care. Next, let's look at the HIV transmission mechanism among American Indian and Alaska Native people in 2018. The CDC data shows that the majority, or 84%, of the reported HIV diagnoses in American Indian and Alaska Native people were among men. Most of the documented HIV transmission among these men was male-to-male sexual contact, accounting for 75% of new diagnoses. The second most common transmission route is injection drugs combined with male-to-male sexual contact, accounting for 15% of new diagnoses. Among American Indian and Alaska Native women, heterosexual contact, at 57%, was the main transmission route, followed by injection drug use at 43%. Other statistics include a recently published CDC report on American Indian and Alaska Native adults in HIV care. This national monitoring project uses in-person and phone interviews that CDC conducts with persons in HIV care. The project seeks to understand better and document the experiences and needs of persons in HIV care. The analysis concentrated on patients who self-reported as American Indian or Alaska Native. These data showed robust patient adherence levels and some room for improvement on viral suppression, which is a crucial indicator for both patient health and preventing HIV transmission. The report showed that, 86% of American Indian and Alaska Native adult patients on antiretroviral therapy were adhering to their care plan. 64% achieved sustained viral suppression. And in the past 12 months before the study, 76% of American Indian and Alaska Native adult patients achieved viral suppression as of their most recent viral load test. The effects of underlying challenges faced by our Native people living with HIV are troubling. Approximately 50% are affected by poverty. Nearly 30% had symptoms of depression. More than 75% reported internalized HIV-related stigma, and 20% reported binge drinking in the past 30 days. From our healthcare providers in Indian country, we hear internally that substance use disorders pose one of the main barriers to treatment adherence in HIV treatment programs. Substance use disorders are overrepresented in rural and poor areas, and Indian country is no exception. Also, poverty can create barriers to consistent care, such as lack of transportation or unstable housing. The well-documented under-resourcing of IHS relative to other national health systems can mean there is limited access to behavioral health or recovery programs. IHS is making innovations in healthcare during COVID-19, such as telehealth. Still, our communities often do not have reliable internet or cell phone data coverage, so the digital divide has a more significant impact than ever before. Most troubling is the high proportion of patients who reported stigma. Stigma can have severe effects on treatment-seeking behavior, mental health, and the ultimate well-being and outcome of our Native people living with HIV. To reduce stigma, those of us working with Native communities must continue our efforts to promote a better understanding of HIV and the fact that we can treat and effectively manage HIV as a chronic disease. Thank you for listening to this HIV data report. I encourage you to stay in touch with IHS activities. To get regular updates from the IHS National HIV Program, please consider subscribing to our IHS HIV listserv. For more information, please go to ihs.gov and search HIV/AIDS. Please remember to check out cdc.gov for a variety of data and statistics on American Indians and Alaska Natives. You may also go to hiv.gov to help increase your knowledge about HIV and discover more about access to HIV services for people at risk for or living with HIV. For more information, please contact Rick Haverkate at the Indian Health Service by email at richard.haverkate@ihs.gov. And please visit our website at www.ihs.gov/HIVAIDS.